Hi, my name is Sarah Hindman, and this is my teaching presentation for Nursing 4365. So my teaching presentation discusses the importance of prenatal care for teenage mothers. Working as a maternal fetal health nurse here in Lubbock, Texas, I encounter a lot of teenage moms that come in for a first or maybe even a subsequent pregnancy. Some of these girls have received prenatal care. Others come in either in the second or third trimester with no or inadequate prenatal care. And so this presentation is just going to overview some of the important reasons that we want these girls to receive the best care possible during their pregnancy leading up to delivery. So I'm going to discuss the importance of adequate prenatal care, risk of inadequate prenatal care and complications that can occur, as well as ways to prevent these complications, and then discuss some of the support groups and different resources for teenage moms in this area. So why is prenatal care so important? The aim of prenatal care is just to ensure the health of mom and baby during pregnancy, all the way up to delivery, and even through the delivery process. Believe it or not, that whole 9 months of growing a baby has a huge impact on the actual delivery, and then of course the health of mom and baby after delivery. So having good prenatal care can help have a good delivery and a good outcome after delivery. So one of the primary important things that we focus on during prenatal care is education and pregnancy planning. This is how we take care of mom and baby during the pregnancy and then planning for delivery as well. So some of the different aspects of prenatal care include things like nutrition. Specifically to teenage moms, we encourage and we educate on good nutrition. Getting enough calories, getting the right kinds of foods, and specifically the right types of nutrients. For teenage moms, we encourage an increased intake of folic acid. Folic acid is important for all pregnancies because having at least 1 gram of folic acid every day helps to prevent open neural tube defects in babies. Open neural tube defects are developmental complications of the brain and the spinal cord early in the pregnancy, and folic acid has been shown to prevent some of these complications of development with that part of the baby. So again, we recommend 1 gram of folic acid every day. We also recommend that moms, specifically young moms, get an adequate intake of iron every day. Younger moms are more at risk for having what's called iron deficient anemia, which is a low blood count from a lack of iron, simply put. So about 325 milligram supplement of iron every day is also important for moms to get. We also, of course, recommend that moms drink plenty of water and stay hydrated throughout the pregnancy, that you increase your calories by about 300 per day. That old saying, eating for two, is pretty outdated and not very accurate. We don't recommend doubling up on everything that you eat because you're pregnant, but it is important to get about 300 extra calories per day. This is going to help ensure that you and baby are getting good nutritional intake and that you're able to maintain a healthy weight or gain a healthy amount of weight during the pregnancy, and therefore provide proper nutrition to baby to grow properly as well. And then, of course, we want to talk about lifestyle choices that you encounter during pregnancy. So it's important what we put in our bodies, obviously, and especially for pregnant mamas, the amount of food, the types of nutrients you get, water, all of that. But there's things that we don't want to put in our bodies. So common sense tells us that smoking and alcohol are something we do not want during pregnancy. Smoking during pregnancy can lead to small babies. smoking has shown to restrict baby's growth and cause babies to either be born early or to be born small. And those two things have their own set of complications that can happen. Alcohol during pregnancy is also a bad idea because, again, smoking and alcohol, they cross the placenta. What goes in your body can cross the placenta and affect the baby, and alcohol can cause baby to have withdrawal symptoms after delivery and cause other problems with the baby, physically and developmentally, things that you may not even see until baby's a little bit older. So it's important that we focus on putting good things in the body and not putting bad things in the body. Another aspect of good prenatal care is the monitoring and the testing that we can do throughout the pregnancy. So moms typically receive about 3 routine ultrasounds during the pregnancy, 1 per trimester, first, second, and third trimesters. And these ultrasounds are important for the doctors to be able to see that baby is growing and developing the way he or she is supposed to. So it's also important to get good prenatal care so that we can track the baby throughout the pregnancy. There are some complications of pregnancy, some developmental things that can occur that we can't always predict or prevent. And so that's just part of the process of watching the baby as he or she grows and making sure that we track growth. Because if baby looks to be small or if the doctor encounters anything else that they see that's abnormal or unusual, then it gives us time, the healthcare team time, to address those specific issues and come up with a plan for how to manage those problems should they occur. So what are some of the risks of inadequate prenatal care? So some complications that are more specific to young moms versus all moms are high blood pressure and gestational diabetes. These two can happen with any mother, but young moms typically are at a little bit higher risk, specifically the high blood pressure. So what is gestational diabetes? Let's start there. So we know that diabetes has to do with blood sugar and insulin and all of that. However, there is a type of diabetes called gestational diabetes that you only get during pregnancy. And any mom is at risk for this, but if you are overweight or if you do have a family history of diabetes, it increases the risk that you could get this gestational diabetes. It does not mean that you have diabetes for the rest of your life or that you have to be on insulin or medications after pregnancy. It's specific to pregnancy. So going back to that testing that we do throughout the pregnancy, that's one test that we do in the late second trimester, early third trimester. It's called a glucose tolerance test. And this glucose tolerance test includes drinking this really sugary drink and then drawing your blood after. And if that glucose level or sugar level in your blood is high, then it could mean that you have gestational diabetes. Uncontrolled diabetes or gestational diabetes can lead to things like type 2 diabetes that can develop later in your life, or specifically for the baby, it can cause baby to be really big, and that can cause the increased risk for things like C-sections or delivery complications if you have a vaginal delivery. So this is part of that screening and monitoring process that we want to do with your prenatal appointments. So we can test for gestational diabetes and we can manage gestational diabetes. A lot of times gestational diabetes is as simple as managing your diet and monitoring more closely the types of food you eat or the quantity you eat. And sometimes that's enough to keep that under control and prevent complications with the baby. The second thing that I talked about was high blood pressure. So young moms specifically, for reasons that even most doctors can't even really explain, young moms are at a higher risk in their first pregnancy of having what's called preeclampsia. And this just means that towards the end of your pregnancy, you develop this high blood pressure that just continues to go up. And we don't know exactly why, and we can't really prevent it, but it does happen. And the best course of action is monitoring mom and keeping track of blood pressures. And if they start to get elevated, to be extra cautious, to monitor with extra ultrasounds, and to watch the pregnancy much more closely, because if the blood pressures get to a certain point, then it could mean that we need to deliver the baby early to prevent mom from having eclamptic seizures, which is a seizure caused by that high blood pressure, or problems with the pregnancy with the baby specifically. So again, one of the reasons that we encourage moms to go to those regular appointments so that if there is a problem, we can identify it as early as possible. And then another complication of pregnancy, or not really of pregnancy, but something that can be a complication to the pregnancy, is unhealthy sexual practices, specifically when it involves having an STI or a sexually transmitted infection. So during pregnancy, again, going back to those tests that we do, there are certain infections, sexually transmitted infections, that can cause complications with either baby's development or complications with delivery itself and to the baby after delivery. So we want to test for certain STDs or STIs during the pregnancy to be sure that we can treat them appropriately with the right type of antibiotics, and then also monitor the baby after delivery. So the whole focus of prenatal care all revolves around being educated and prepared, knowing how to prevent problems, looking for problems, catching them as soon as possible, and being able to manage them closely, again, to ensure the health of mom and baby. And those are just a few of the things that can come up. There are other things, and we definitely don't want to put stress or anxiety on new moms, especially young moms, but it's about being educated. Knowledge is power, and when you're educated, you can make those good decisions and choices and know how to manage your own health and the health of your baby, your child. Lastly, there's a lot of support groups and resources for teenage moms in Lubbock. Both of our hospitals are major hospitals, University Medical Center and Covenant Medical Center, both have a lot of resources for new moms, even specifically teenage moms. There's childbirth classes. You have the options of doing tours of the hospital, seeing where baby's going to be delivered, and getting familiar with the hospital system and how that whole process works. And then support groups as well. Also, there's classes that you can take. Again, childbirth classes, infant care classes, classes that teach you about car seats, breastfeeding, all those different things involved in taking care of a newborn and a baby after delivery. We want moms to be prepared for everything that comes after delivery. My focus, of course, is on the health of mom and baby during the pregnancy and then, of course, at delivery. But there's also a lot that happens after delivery, and we want to offer you the best available resources possible. There's several pregnancy centers in Lubbock, specifically Park Ridge Pregnancy Care here in Lubbock, that offers classes as well. They also offer resources for getting items for the baby, diapers, formula, clothes, different things like that. If finances are a concern and providing for the baby in that way is a challenge, then Park Ridge is great at offering resources for new moms. There's also the Nurse Family Partnership, and this is one of my personal favorite resources to get new moms involved with. The Nurse Family Partnership is a national organization, but they have locations here in Texas and here in Lubbock that partner a nurse with a new mom. And this nurse follows the mom through her pregnancy, through the delivery process, more of at a distance, but then really that partnership comes into play after delivery. And that nurse will team up with that mom and follow her throughout the baby's first year of life. The nurse is a great resource to learn about, again, infant care, breastfeeding, maintaining well child checkups and making sure baby goes to all their appointments, because there are a lot and it can be confusing. But that nurse is also there to answer questions about baby having fever or teething or eating or different sleeping problems or whatever it may be. That nurse is a great resource, and she will walk alongside that mom, that family, throughout the first year of life and just be a good resource and a good support system throughout that whole time. So just to kind of recap, the importance of adequate prenatal care is about being educated, knowing what to expect, how to manage the pregnancy, and the things that we can do to help have a healthy mom and a healthy baby all throughout pregnancy, at delivery, and of course after delivery. There's complications that can happen. There's different things like gestational diabetes and high blood pressure that are fairly common, but can be prevented or at least monitored very closely and managed well, as long as you maintain your prenatal appointments and stay in contact with your nurse and doctor's office and follow the guidelines that we give you to maintain those healthy practices and be on top of any complications that might come up so that we can act on them as quickly as possible to prevent any bad outcomes. And then, of course, there's all those resources that are available in our community. And there's many more than what I listed here. These are just some of the more common resources and support options for patients, but they are available. And the bottom line is that pregnancy can be very daunting. There's a lot going on, and it's a lot of new responsibility and information to undertake. But you do have support systems that are available and lots of good information, lots of resources for help. And we are here to help you go through that whole process and, again, have a healthy pregnancy and a healthy baby.